Hello and welcome to another Roblox tutorial. So this is the third video of creating a keycard door in Roblox Studio. And in this video, we are going to be configuring the keycard and making the doors actually usable in our game. So the first thing we have to do is add a button part to our model, as well as a billboard GUI to show the player what key they should press in order to open the door. So I will do that right now. So there we go. So what I did is I made a part in my door model and called it button, and I put a billboard GUI with the always on top property set to true in my button. And I made a simple text label with the key I want my user to press. In this case, it's E, because E is usually like the interact key, so it should be able to be used to open a door. And yeah, that's basically it. Now, this is purely aesthetic. There is no functional value in our script for this part, but it's highly recommended that you make it. It just makes your door a lot more interactive and look a lot better. And make sure, when you are making your billboard GUI and text label, that you want to set the scale value, not the offset value. So the scale value is this little first number in the brackets in each of these. So each of these is for X and Y, and this is scale and then offset. You want to set the scale value, because if you set the offset, it'll look really weird farther away. So make sure to do that. Same with the text label. Set the first number of the curly brackets for each one. So yeah, now you have your button set. So the next thing you want to do is to create a remote event in replicated storage. This is going to be used to communicate from your keycard tool to the server to open the door. I'm going to name this toggle door state, because this is what we will be using it for. So now that we have our door and our remote event set up, now let's actually make the keycard. So I have a little part right here, which is going to be my keycard. If you want a part to be your like model for your tool, you have to name it handle with a capital H. So now let's make a tool in the starter pack, and I'm going to name this tool keycard. Whoops, typo there, key card without the slash. And I'm going to take my handle, whatever I want, and shove it in the key card. And make sure to design this in the workspace before you just like make a part, because you don't want a default part as your key card. That would look pretty ugly. So now we're going to make a local script in our little key card. And I'm going to name this the key card handler. And let's start scripting. So the first thing you have to do is define a few things. First thing I'm going to define is the context action service. And what this service allows you to do is get keyboard input and like bind it to a function. And then you can unbind it once you're done with it. So this is perfect for our situation. So let's get the context action service. There we go. And we also want to get our tool, local keycard equals script.parent, so that is our keycard. And we also want to get our remote event, so local toggle state event equals game.replicated storage, wait for child, toggle door state. That's the event that we want. And the reason we're using wait for child is just to make sure it is loaded in. So the first thing we want to do in the script is define a function, toggle door state. And this function is going to take three parameters: action name, input state, and input object. Change that to be camel case. So with this function is going to fire whenever a keyboard event happens to our designated keys. We will define those a little bit later. So this will fire when you press a key and when you release a key and like during a key press. So we only want this to occur at the start of a key press, because you don't want a door to open when you press a key, and then when you release a key, it closes again. That'd be stupid. So let's make it so if the input state equals enum.userInputState.begin, then we fire our toggle state event. So the reason we're doing this is so you press a key down and it fires this event. When you release it, it does not fire this event. And when we fire this event, we will check for our surrounding door, see which one's closest, and then we open that door. But we will do that a little bit later. Now we actually need to fire this function. So the way we're going to do that is using tool events. So with our tool, the key card, there are a few events. The ones we want to use are equipped and unequipped. So tool.equipped, and we're going to connect this to a function. And in this function, we want to bind a action using the context action service. So we're going to use a function bind action. And so when you bind action, you basically take a bunch of inputs, like whether it be a gamepad input or a keyboard input, and you bind it to a function. That's why we made this function toggle door state up there. So the parameters it takes in is the name of the action. This is good for unbinding it. So we're going to make this name the toggle door state. It's not really important. You just have to remember it. And the function, the next parameter is the function we want to fire whenever the input that we will define is like clicked or pressed. And we want to do toggle door state. Make sure there is no parentheses with this function or your game will error. And after that, this boolean designates whether we want a mobile button. So on mobile devices, like a little touch button will appear. Since I'm on computer, I'm not going to use this. And then the next variables, depending on how many inputs you want, is for what buttons you will press in order to trigger this action, this function. So for me, I'm going to do E, since as you saw with my service GUI, my billboard GUI with my text label in it, I set that to E. So I'm going to make this E just to make it the same, because that makes sense. And this is all good. We have our binded action when we equip the tool. But when you unequip it, you should not be able to open the door. And so now we're going to do keycard.unequipped. And we're going to connect another function. And this function, we are going to unbind an action. And we have to do the same name. And that's it. Because we are turning this action off. So what this is going to do is whenever we equip our tool, and whenever our tool is equipped, and we click the button E, and it's the beginning of our button press, we will fire the server this event. And whenever you unequip it, you will not be able to open the door. And this event will open our door. And so we will do that next. So now let's go to our server scripts and allow our door to be opened. So the first thing I'm going to do is go into the door handler and define our remote event to open the door or toggle the door. So local toggle state event equals game.replicated storage. Wait for child toggle door state. So now that we have our event, the next thing we want to do is go into our door module and add a new variable. Now, this variable is going to be door.doors, and it's going to be a table. This variable is going to hold all of our door tables, because when we want to go through them to see which one's the closest, we'll need like a full list of them. And in order to add doors to this table, whenever we go create a new door and door new, we will do table.insert door.doors, because this defines what table you want to insert into, and we'll insert our new door table. So this will do is this will insert our new door into our table of door.doors, and we will use this table in just a moment. So now that we have our door.door set up, which will be just all of our doors, because notice this collection service get tag doors, this is all the models. It's not the actual tables that we create down here. And the next thing we want to do is add a event for when our toggle state event fires. So I'm going to do toggle state event on server event connect function, and the parameter we will have is the player, because whenever you fire a server event from the client, it will automatically send whichever player fired it. And this is good because we need the player. And the first thing we're going to define here is the position of the player. So player pose is going to be equal to the player dot character dot primary part dot position. So it just basically gets the position of the character of our player. And we're just using primary part since we need like a position, and you can't get a position from a model. And so that's what we're going to use. And then we need to define a table, which is going to be distances. And this is going to be the distance, like each door's distance away from the player. Because we want the system to be available for multiple doors. So what we're going to have to do is measure the distance between each door, and whichever one is the closest is the one we will open. And speaking of that, let's add another variable at the top of our script, and this is going to be called proximity. And this is going to be how close the player has to be to the door for it to open. And we will use that in just a second. So the first thing we have to do is fill the distances table. So I'm going to do for I door in pairs door module dot doors. So this gets the table of door tables that we have in our door module. What we're going to do here is we are going to get the door distance, which is equal to the door dot model dot primary part dot position. And actually, speaking of that, I'm going to set my door primary part to the button, because we want to know how close you are to the button. So door.primaryPart.position minus playerPose.magnitude. So what this line of code right here does is it takes the position of the door, which is a vector 3, and we subtract that from the player position, which is also a vector 3. And this gives you a vector 3. But since a vector 3 isn't like a variable, like it's not an integer for distance, dot magnitude basically gets like the distance of the vector 3 between the door position and the player position. This is just some simple vector math. You don't really have to understand it to use it. So after that, we are going to insert into the distances table the door distance. So there we go. And next we need another for loop in order to actually see which door is the closest. Door module dot doors. We're going to get the door distance again. And we can just use door I for this because this will run in the same order as we did earlier, and so we can use I to get whichever door's distance that we need. And the reason we have to do this in two for loops is because we can't like compare distances before we have all of the distances in one table. Okay, so after this, we have to use an if statement right here, and what we're gonna do here is check what door distance is the closest. So how we're going to do this is we're going to do if math.min, and we're going to do unpack door, actually not door, it'd be distances, equals door distance, and door distance is less than proximity, then we will toggle the door's state. And if you recall, the way we do that is we do door toggle state. So what this is going to do is it unpacks the distances table, which basically just turns it into a bunch of like numbers. And math.min takes a bunch of numbers separated by commas to like, and it finds the minimum, like the least number in it. So we have to unpack the table for math.min. Math.min finds the smallest number in the table of distances. And if the smallest number is equal to the current door distance in our little for loop right here, and this door distance is less than proximity. The reason we have this is because if you're, like, super far away from the door, but it's, like, the closest door to you, you still don't want that door to open. You want to have, like, a base proximity, which in my case is 10 studs up here. We want to open and or close the door. So, let's try it out. So, I made a slight syntax error. Instead of door, it should be distances. This was a pretty stupid mistake. But now, if we try it out, the door should open. So look at that. The door opens and closes. So this works perfectly. And if I run away, I'm clicking E, doesn't work. If I don't have the key card out, clicking E doesn't work. So I have the key card be pretty close. And another thing you can do is in our door handler, we can go to this initial for loop where we declare our new door, is we can go to the door model and set the door dot button dot billboard GUI dot max distance and set this equal to our proximity plus 7.5. So what this will do is this will set the max distance of our billboard GUI to our proximity and then some. And the reason we're doing this is so you can only see, like, the little E, or, like, the GUI, when you're close enough to open the door. And the reason I'm doing plus 7.5 is because, in reality, this does not appear how close, like, your player how close your player is. It only appears, like, with your camera. So you kind of, like, it depends how zoomed in or zoomed out you are. So you kind of just have to guess. So now, if we're, like, sort of close to our door, we can open it. If we're farther away, you can't see the E, and you cannot open it. So that's just a cool little side feature that you can do. And, yeah, that's basically it for our door. And I've told you this system is expandable, so now I'm going to demonstrate that right now. I made two doors. So this is a clone of the door. It should also be tagged. Let me just check that real quick. Tag window. Door. Tagged instances. Yes, we got the two doors here. So we have our two doors right here. And they should work in tandem. Let's try that out. So we can open this door pretty easily. We can leave that open. Oh, and look at that. We can open both doors. So you can open and close this one, and open and close this one. And they both work fine. And since I'm closer to this one opens. And if I'm, like, in between them, I'm actually too far away. But you can open and close whichever door you want. So, this system works with as many doors as you want. That's why we did all of the extra little math and stuff for, like, the vectors and stuff. Just to check which door is closest. So, yeah, that's basically it. This system is very useful. I'm actually pretty proud of it. I really hope you enjoyed this series. I put a lot of work into it, and I'm pretty proud of the result. And make sure to like and subscribe. If you have any questions, please comment them down below, because this was pretty complex, if I have to say so myself. And I hope you have a nice day, and goodbye.